The National Anthem of Georgia.
Welcome everybody to Parma in Northern Italy. It is match day number 3 and it is the conclusion of the under 18 Six Nations Festival for both England and Georgia.
Back right.
England kicked off into their own arms, chasing their own kick. And in that iconic white jersey, this festival back for the third consecutive year. The wake of COVID and welcoming two new nations in Portugal and Georgia.
Option.
Widening the
pool
of teams to wait.
Okay.
And also riding a bit of history as far as these junior Lilos are concerned. a marquee victory against France last time out, whilst for England they're looking to go through the competition undefeated. And he secured victories against Scotland and, most memorably, Wales.
Step forward.
Last-minute effort. Lucas Friday, they're starting at scrum half for England today, having been blighted by injuries throughout his school's career this year. His last year at Trinity School, but unable to really take the field. All of his mates, but back in time for English duties. Lorenzo Negro, our Italian man in the middle. Awards a penalty first up to this Georgian side, who have a lot of interest in. There's a lot of expectation within Georgian rugby around this under 18 age category. It's widely anticipated that many of them will join the 20s later this summer when they have tests against England. They have tests against France, and then they head to South Africa for the World Rugby Under 20s Championships. And I've been reliably informed to expect Georgian flair, as it was labelled to me, from this age group. Gone are the days of maybe the lazy assumption that it is all power and forward dominance from Georgian rugby. There are some real architects out in the back division, and players who can go from power to poise to penetrative running in a moment's notice. But unfortunately, we won't get to see that back line sing just yet, because the throw isn't straight. The scrum put in is England's.
Okay, more closer.
And the starting front row of Josh Mann, Jimmy Staples and Sam Graham will be hoping for a better outcome than the penalty they just gave away against Archil Nozadze, Andriy Shivalidze and Georgi Torashvili. Stadio Sergio Lanfranchi has been treated to some magic moments across this under 18s festival.
Stay up and push straight.
The packs engage, and here comes the power, and here comes the captain of England, Conor Treacy, the Bath Academy man. Really is some talent. So many of these players have got to know each other, playing against each other in the Premiership Academy League, but they won't have got to know much about these Georgians, other than they have come here to rattle cages and shake up the status quo. That victory against France, first in the Six Nations, and a thunderous shot forces the pass forward. So Tyler Afire can't be set free, but the big shoulder of Data Akvelediani coming in and halting England's progress.
Hold. No, guys. Yeah, shut. Stop.
Was it the first time that Georgia had beaten France? They'd beaten them in the European Championships back in the day when France used to mix it with Georgia a little more regularly. How about that for a meaty carry in the midfield? Good low hit coming in from Treacy. He's back on his feet and tracking across as Georgia make their way across to the right edge. Bit of a juggle from Kalavashi. It's a line out to England. A little bit scrappy, these opening salvos.
Okay. On the line.
Nice and clean and swiftly off the top, and another thunderous shot coming in from Daviti Babakadze on this occasion. The two centres creating destruction. And the pass forward. That was slipped out was in fact slipped forward. But penalty advantage.
14 offside.
And between the 12 and the 13 of Georgia, I think a pretty uncompromising defensive message has been sent to England. That there are 15 sets of shoulders out there eager to tickle the rib cages of the England players. Gigi Siarbaladze, who last time you saw him was wearing 22 and was being enveloped by his teammates. He's the man who nervelessly slotted the touchline conversion to seal the most famous of victories over France. He knows, shows no sight of early nerves here as Georgia deservedly get the first points of the game and they lead England 3-0. James Lineker, who's no stranger to a nerveless conversion himself, his last-ditch effort, sealing victory against Wales, gets us underway. It's a real rare talent, the Bath boy. Still a year young as well. He was in the under-18s Academy League as early as last season. There is huge excitement surrounding the fly half.
No. Ball is there, not looking for penalty.
And Lorenzo Negro rightly identifies a young scrum half looking to milk a penalty. Tells Siclauri to get on with it. Up high, too long, and a chance for England to counter from deep. Good tackle, low, and hands on the ball, but just about prized away in time. Hint of Backford offside there from the Georgians as Treacy gives Akveliadiani the treatment, a fire. A little bit of a skip off the right boot.
Okay, double choice. One is here, and one there, Connor. One penalty here, and one near the middle, there. Yeah. 2 meters back.
How far out?
Yeah, it's in the half. Okay.
Well, Lineker.
I take up.
He was just asking how far away. I think he might have had a long shot a goal in mind, but instead he looks to chew off as much of the touchline as he can. Takes England up to the doorstep of the 22. And the first opportunity for England to bring the noise to Georgia in an attacking sense. Oh, the overthrow undoes those ambitions and Georgia clear the decks. It's a really good kick. It's well fielded and well returned. First kicking duel of the afternoon here in the resplendent sunshine of Northern Italy. Great contest and it's a bouncing ball that needs an owner. Eventually gets one. That is outstanding work, isn't it? England being hassled and harried in every department at the moment, and it's forcing errors. But fortunately for them, that aerial contest adjudged to have been knocked forward by Georgia.
Hop,
great support from friends and family. Can't imagine it was too tough a sell, was it? Would you like to come to Palma for a week and watch the next generation of international European stars go toe-to-toe? Sample some decent food and drink while you're up there as well, I'd imagine. He can get the penalty. And, well, Lorenzo Negro is still explaining away the decision. And Lucas Friday's up and driving England across the halfway line. Nice hands low to the deck. And England have got a bit of a roll on. Again, that press defence and flirting with the offside line, Luca Gabunia. And again, a handling error from England. This time, no advantage for them to lean back on. And Lineker's fumble. Hands possession back to the Georgians.
Okay.
Come on, let's get back at them.
Okay, contact.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm here. Here
we go, Sam. Hold your weight. Hold me back.
Crouch! Burn! Set!
Early push. The scrum at the moment is a dissatisfying battleground if you're into this style of set piece. Very few to be completed thus far.
Okay. That's the exact same thing again.
Okay. Keep the pressure. Hold your weight, okay?
Yeah, we are, but
it's nice to hear 17 and 18 year olds piping up and telling the referee exactly how they feel they're being aggrieved in the scrum there. Sam Graham there on the tight head for England, Josh Mann on the other side, and their opposite men of Archil Ozadze and Georgi Turashvili. Quick service for the backs. Second layer comes in, then the skip ball and a juggle on the bounce and almost reeled in.
Option.
A real ambition being shown by the Georgians off first phase, but the pass too tricky to handle at pace for Giga Kipchidze.
Five.
Off the top, nice shakes from England, but again the passing a little errant. The Georgians again demonstrating their hunger to defend, swung back to the 22.
What is there? Stay.
Friday seeks a bit of additional scaffolding on the caterpillar. Oh, just the presence there was enough to unsettle the Georgian fullback, Nicolosi Kalvashi.
First knock on the catch, on the pass, if you see a clear deliberate knock on by 10 red. No, just scrum. Okay, I agree.
Interesting, there was no actual competition for the up and under, but just the near presence in the windscreen of the onrushing white jerseys enough to see Kalvashi knock on. Some treatment he delivered to Tornike Toradze.
Water break. Water break, water break.
The Georgian
and
fans supporting their boys who were the current Rugby Europe water champions break, and have been many times over the last 15. Few years.
Scrum is there, some injury, water break.
And some good heritage in amongst them as well. Luka Saginadze, brother of Georgian international Becker, Leon Espoir.
I'm not sure on the pass. Later,
there is
given the temperatures,
corner,
given the sun.
So.
It seems only right to go and seek a bit of shade and some hydration. And you can see there the water spray as well. That's a water carrier upgrade right there.
Don't listen.
Now charged with misting the players. Well, it's been a wonderful week for these young men, just as it's been for all eight of the nations stationed here in Palma. The opportunity to pull on the jersey of your nation, to spend time on tour with a core of boys all questing for the same goal, victory for your country, further professional progression themselves. And for Georgia, they fly a flag not just for their country, but for the tier two. They fly the flag for the nations desperate to dine at the top table of international rugby, from age group to senior, with increased regularity, and as has been the Georgian way across all those teams over these recent years. They've made waves. Huge win over France, sending a message that the current crop of Georgians are no one-off. There's a pipeline. More stability being sought at the scrum. And Georgia looking to crumble the English. A little pop from the base and the backs are free. First carry through the centres of real meaning for England. Dribbled on the toe and a fire encouraged to chase. But the touchline beats them all. Tyler Afire, products of not just Wellington College, but London Irish Academy, now known as London South Central. A try and an assist of note in this competition already. Georgia go to the tail. And they get a bit of momentum on their drive too. It was this weapon that delivered what turned out to be the winning try against France, but here showing that it can chew off meters closer to their line. Look at that for a punishing carry from the big inside center, Babakadze. Touched by England.
High tackle number 10.
And Lineker penalised for a high tackle
10,
on that bullocking inside centre of Georgia.
Above the sternum, careful guys.
Tough call maybe, looks like he got on the ball. But in the interest of building better long-term habits, do one. Youngsters going as low as possible in the tackle, though easy said from here, because I don't have Daviti Babakadze running at me.
Four or five.
Bledzidze misses his man. It's scooped up by Jimmy Staples.
Release!
Oh, real pressure being offered by the Georgian press, and England are struggling to handle the attentions that they're getting.
Away 14.
A little bit of fun and games between Siklauri and the Fire.
Okay, England.
Moment. England being suffocated by this Georgian defence.
Let's go.
Georgia.
Tie.
Too lackadaisical to join their own line out, so a free kick to England.
Okay, let's go.
A quarter of the match played, and really.
Stay.
Nothing too remarkable Stay. To report other than the Siribalidze penalty. But a spiral bomb always puts the cat amongst the pigeons. Artfully taken.
Stay. Onside.
And returned.
Stay.
Big booming boots all round, and Siribalidze content to call the mark.
Yeah. Hold. Whenever you want. Touch!
England across the halfway line, but conceding a penalty for holding on. Patrick Hogan, a man adjudged to have wrapped his arms around it that second too long. Hogan, I of course meant Patrick Hogg of the Newcastle Falcons, educated at Durham School. I'd be originally at Blade, in one of the great clubs up in the north. Georgia looking to get this driving more going. Savadar Chvadze, the replacement hookers, nestled into the nucleus of that mass of bodies, and England may have just managed to get some tentacles on it. Georgia break, they carry directly through their battering ram, Babakadze. Siklauri. Marshalling forwards and backs around, messy presentation. England sends the counter ruck.
No hands! Ball is there, ball is there. Stop it, stop it, stop it, wait.
Very, very slow ball. England reorganise. They throw some bodies into the defence. Elliot Williams in amongst it, the England second row, and a real battleground out there. No cross kick, but a little chip into open space, and I tell you what, if that dead ball area had been a little deeper, Calavasi could have been pouncing.
Eight wide, off it. You were straight on the ball, but you have to support your body weight. You go off feet. Yeah, thank you.
Second penalty in England waters. Get sized up.
30.
I see a lad there. He's in no rush. but makes absolutely sure. Georgia double their leads here in Parma. They lead England 6 points to nil. England again, very, very good kickoff routine. There's definitely unattended ground right at the front of that Georgian reception, close to the 10-meter line, and England are rewarded. Lineker looking to massage the defence, bringing his back division in. Slick hands, super speed with a fire. Try time for England in the right-hand corner. The men in white strike. Well, it all came from Lineker's read of that rush. And then it was composure. It was Dan Green. It was Tyler Afire. It was no stopping the flyer from that range. What about the handling? What about the execution from England? Afire's name will go to it, but he had the simplest job of them all. But they all need to be finished. And he's showing early in his England age group career and he's got try-scoring instincts. No extras to add from the England fly half, but the first try of the match. England still trail, but the difference is a point. And Lineker's dummy, those soft hands and the delayed ball from Israel back in Rowe. An easy streak for Tyler Afire into the corner. Good contest called as Kipchirze makes a nuisance of himself in the Parma skies. Lovely soft hands frees up Sam Graham, who gets stopped beyond the 22. Lineker fizzes it on one more, but behind the ears of Rafe Witteat.
Okay, white on the line.
Wonderful adventure from England, but the error has put them immediately under the pump. To the tail, Georgia go. To the midfield, they surge. Tepid tackling gives front foot momentum to the Georgians. Georgians who come rampaging round the corner. The replacement hooker, Archvadze, stopped in his tracks by Williams. This time, it's Saganadze. Back to the original infringement and, oh, England's punishing themselves here with indiscipline.
Okay, we have a penalty here and one right there for the 13 here. 13, I take on shot call.
Another eminently kickable penalty that, by the looks of things, is going to be sent over the crossbar.
13, I take on. Okay, against your number one, it was dipping, but the contact was direct with the shoulder, with hand on head, But in this one way upright, so it was a take. Okay, okay, I watch that.
No doubt about it.
Seven.
Any penalties within kickable range, Gigi Siabeladze will punish you. Georgia up to nine. They stretch their lead. 11 minutes and a bit of change left of the first half. Well, I tell a lie. They're 35-minute halves in the under-18s festival. 70-minute matches, so just six to go.
Use it!
Georgia at the moment, you have to say, are the team with the most control. England show they can strike, but they're lacking continuity at the moment. Two white jerseys get in the way of one another. A bit of a sore landing as well for that young man.
Men on the ground, them off.
Sam Graham.
Yeah, the kick.
Getting the fluids on.
Yeah, them, yeah.
Nice in
yeah,
the neck.
Stop.
Justifiably, this has been.
One step forward, it stops and you come back. So
rewarding yet punishing. No, few days of under-18s festival action, three matches.
Okay.
It all started on the 30th of March. For England, it's victories over Wales and Scotland, whilst for Georgia, it was defeat to Scotland first up. And of course, that win over France. One more match to go today.
Yeah,
at the Stadio Sergio Lanfranchi.
Crunch! Bye! Set! Stay!
Georgia, the scrum heading in reverse, a hint of a nibble from the eight there, and then a loss of footing and grip from Siabeladze. Siklauri bombs it up into the skies, and again that chase is so good from Kipchirchir. Finds a fire, a bit flat-footed, and England fortuitously come away with possession. Carry forward by Sepp Kelly. Forwards and backs linking up. Lineker picking the passes again. Showing his rugby IQ. And while Friday might remonstrate with the referee, it's Georgia who get the penalty call.
No, there were, but you release immediately.
What happens here? What's your range like, Gigi Siabeladze? Not sufficient to call for the tee. Instead, he misses touch.
Stay for two, stay.
England instead send it across the touchline. While he may have missed touch, net is much of a muchness, really. An early change at hooker for Georgia, not seemingly having an impact negatively on their line out. A lot of movement, and it goes to the banker, ball at the front. Archvadze adds himself to the equation, but brought down. Advantage here for Georgia. Number 24, Ika Kavrakshelika is on. Crossfield kick, gobbled up on the glide. And Georgia now probing down the short side. No way through for Sick Lowry.
Right, well job. Come back. Number five, collapse the ball.
But it was advantage. John O'Balding. The man adjudged to have been up to nefarious activity in that rolling mall. Two minutes, I think, the referee telling the players out there.
Six.
An ominous signs here for England. They don't compete. Question marks over how straight that throw was, but Archvadze won't question. He'll latch. He'll push. He'll propel. He'll try to surge to the line. England doing well to get hands on. Then the bodies cluster round and Negro on his haunches, looking for a sign, but held up fabulously by England. The arm of Patrick Hogg proving decisive there at the bottom of the melee of bodies.
One minute left.
Final minute of this first half.
Crouch.
One that's maybe lacked the try-scoring razzmatazz of the matches that have gone before, those on previous match days, but Georgia will be very, very happy with the way that they've impressed themselves upon England here. Sol Shand.
Stay.
I beg your pardon, it was Israel Akinrowo carrying the unglamorous meters there as Treacy was taken out.
Last play.
Final play of the half, Georgia. Georgia will want to take some points from this pressure. They've been down in the England half for some time now. It would be a feather in the England cap if they're to emerge with their try line unscathed. Poor handling though from Georgia means that England will take that positive into the halftime huddles. And after 35 minutes here in Palmer, three penalties to the Georgians. And one very snappy try indeed from that man there, Tyler Rafaia. Means as the teams head for the huddles and they seek shade in these red hot conditions here in Northern Italy. It's Georgia who lead England 9-5. Well, here is the sole try from the half, and
exactly
what a try it was. Those hands, the no look from Akinrowo. Dan Green released. Tyler Afire obliging with the try scoring finish. It doesn't matter what way you chop it up, what angle you go from. This first phase strike was an absolute pearler. Half time here in Palmer. England under 18s, 5. Georgia under 18s.
charge. I was still the same, ain't nothing changed except the car key. Vroom, vroom. I told her to gas me up. I need the gasoline. I'm trying to slide it in, just like a cash machine. I made a million on this phone with a crack screen. So don't beat around the bush, please say what you mean. Thank you.
England and Georgia return to the field of play, and well, the DJ has got the place rocking here in Palmer. The players are yet to truly give the crowd a reason to be dancing in the stands. There was one moment to get off your feet. That was the try from Tyler Afire, but otherwise it has been a performance from both sides that have lacked a bit of accuracy, maybe demonstrated an element of gameplay fatigue. But this man has been a sharp shooter. Three penalties from his right boot means that Georgia lead England 9-5 with 35 minutes remaining of the 2024 Under-18 Six Nations Festival, and another poor pass stretching the hamstrings of Dan Green isn't cleanly taken, and Georgia go berserking through the middle of the England defence. England scrambling early, architects of their own downfall here at the moment. Georgia need cool heads, they need strong bodies, they need pumping pistons of limbs. This obdurate England defence standing firm so far and battering them back. Saganadze picks, goes, is stopped, and that is unbelievable breakdown work. The captain, Connor Treacy, standing and delivering.
Hold on. Go back 10, guys. Back 10.
Big clearance from James Lineker. Just see here, Treacy biding his time, waiting for his opportunity, and then pouncing precisely. Stolen at the line out by Georgia. England set piece, not pairing at the moment, that's for sure. And Georgia feasting on these errors from England. So new scrum half on for Georgia.
Okay, use it, 21.
Zodzuashvili puts a bit of snow on this one. Chase, as ever, very, very good from these young Georgians.
Okay, play advantage offside number 5.
Lineker hoists one high. He knows he's got penalty advantage for the offside.
Number 5 offside. Number 5.
Again, offside. England five. Fumbling around for a bit of fluency. Staples, the Harlequin hooker, needs to find that connection with his jumpers. They go safe at the front, no one leaves the ground. Jamie Miller receiving at the front before Treacy bulldozes his way up to the halfway line. Beautiful soft hands in the middle again from England. A fire on the switch, popping out of the tackle, but to nobody.
15 release.
Defence very flirtatious with that back foot offside at the breakdown. All there, right in front, operating in the grey areas. Another ball out the back. Lineker decides not to dish it to Hogg, and he gets clattered for his troubles. Well, the basketball pass over the top from the new man, Basilea. Now the gap opens up and these second rows are beginning to canter through.
Now you lose it!
Zodzu Ashvili, content with slow ball. He's got really powerful young men around him. Out the back, into the 15-meter channel. Georgia looking to open England up, but Kipchidze's fingertips can't stretch quite that far forward. He's worked really hard, the left winger, but you have to say that the service he has been provided hasn't matched his endeavour thus far. Finally, England claim one of their own. Counter on offer for the Georgians. Here's that Georgian flair roaring through the middle. You see the eyes up, head on a swivel, looking for the offloads before the big men go plundering forward. Bullocking through England tackles. That's Nozadze.
Okay, seven, stay.
The momentary lapse from Sir Valadze robs us of a bit of rhythm. We'll have another scrum. Very highly rated. The young fly half. We've got quiet excitement about his future. There's no better team to be showing off your talents. Zura Amanashvili, the head coach of this under-18s outfit for Georgia. He's involved in the 20s setup as well. Really, there is
Georgia,
clear
Georgia,
pathway
please, one,
for these
three and five
young but mountainous
one,
men
three and five
to go up through into the 20s, up for senior representation. It would be an age grade game of rugby without an aggressive mullet. This one in the stands. Halfback pairing of Lineker and Friday make way. Lucas Friday, his old man, will be tuning in from somewhere in Hong Kong, having been busy with the USA Eagles. That's the most famous historic sevens tournament in the world. There is fresh opportunity now for others to make their names. Johnny Wyman on at scrum half. Here for England. And feeding. And breaking. Off England go. Down the left edge. Great pace injected. And the ball remarkably coming away in England hands. It was a speculator. But it was all in a bid to keep the ball alive. Graham. Hit low and hard. Ball fist across the face. But getting the Georgian defence standing up well. They're not an easy bunch of boys to run through. And a knock on forced. And England spun on their heels. Green. In a spot of bother here. Huge pressure, charge down, slip through the grass with the next Georgian arrival. England breathe a momentary sigh of relief before They fill their lungs and they ready themselves for another defensive exertion and examination. Archvadze goes half back. Again, that ambition to free up the hands and squeeze out an offload. Kumaritovi on the piggyback through the hole there. The new halfback looking to put a bit of tempo in there.
Okay, okay, good job, Conor. Don't worry, stay there. Stay.
England working so hard in defence now as Kumaritovi picks and goes, and the meters hard to come by.
Okay, ready? 9-7.
Clock making a nuisance of himself there. Well, tell you what, Archvadze wasn't expecting that. He did well to hold on, didn't he? An angle against the grain, too tight. Too much demanded of the handling skills. Knocked forward, and again, an impressive defensive display from England. Jonathan Pendlebury said of this group in the week, he said that they were relishing the challenge. But the coaches, across the entirety of the festival, they've been
Number eight.
Hugely impressed with the headstrong mentality and described the cohesion in the group as a brotherhood. I think.
Okay. Water off, please.
It's demonstrative in the way that they're defending right now. Georgia really coming close to breaching the England whitewash so far this afternoon. But they do, however, lead on the scoreboard. No points in this second half so far. Wyman. That's a good carry. That should breathe some life into the England attack. Israel Akinrowo, the man responsible for the meters. Wyman picks out Kalvashi. Georgia put in a contestable one up there. It's well watched by John O'Balding. And Georgia are offside on the chase there. Treacy isn't hanging around. He wants to play. Oh my goodness. And that is such a let off for England. I have to admire the enterprise from the captain, trying to inject some life into this England attack, but he would count himself fortunate to have got the penalty back and 10 further metres advanced as well. Green finds a good touch.
Advantage was over. 10.
Jimmy Staples. There's Jamie Miller at the front. We're waiting for a few replacements here, though. So Kelly's race is run by the sounds of things.
Okay, let's go.
21. Ollie Allport is on. Now, this Gloucester man. It's partial to a worldie. Watch out for the impact that this back rower can make. And linking up with Treacy, it's a potent pairing as well. Archvadze penalised for collapsing and coming in from the side. So England will roll the attacking dice here. Now knock on once again. Urgency from Johnny Wyman. He wants the ball. He wants to go.
16 side entry and collapse. Okay, stay.
Jamie Miller, the Harlequin, on the shoulder of the Falcons, Sam Graham. He gives it to Treacy, the Bath man, who grapples and rides his way to the line. Brought down a metre shy. Graham! Won't be denied from point blank range. England have a second. And for the first time in this match, they have the lead. The big man from Durham City Rugby Football Club bullying his way across the line. And Dan Green makes no mistake from right in front. Georgia now have to respond. Weather conditions here a little different to Hollow Drift, where Durham City Rugby Club play their home games. But prospering in the sunshine nevertheless. Sam Graham, a big try for this England under-18s outfit, who have been second best throughout this game. But right now, it's Georgia who are second best on the scoreboard. Tangled up on the 10-metre line. That's a good hit, but it doesn't stick from Jimmy Staples. Georgia forced the play a little bit now, and a few new faces onto the field.
21, stop it, please. We are playing advantage for high tackle.
High tackle advantage being played against England. Tavari on at fly half. Georgia into the 15-metre channel, touchline. Acting as the 16th man.
Nothing there.
There's three more white jerseys pour in.
Number
but
three,
it was advantage already. So Saba Shavashidze chips the ball back in field. And Luca Tavori. Puts the left laces through that.
Number three,
and takes Georgia
three,
to 10 metres from 14, the English line.
14. No. Subs.
Sam Graham's making way.
Yeah.
Try secured. Is they done?
Wait. Okay, here. That's great. Old. Okay, let's go.
Georgia take it cleanly. And they build a blockade of big boys. Some long English tentacles come over the top. They need to solve the Elliot Williams problems. Who's in there? He's still got his arms on the ball and getting levitated to the line. But Georgia grapple their way to the line and to the floor. And it's David Archvadze, the hero for the big red machine, unstoppable from the driving maul.
Water break after that. 18.
No extras to add, but a try that puts Georgia back into the lead by two. It's incredible work initially by Elliot Williams. But as the impetus continued to come from the Georgians, he was lifted out of the equation, and that man there has not just handed Georgia the lead, but he's taken them to 14 points, which is as many as Georgia have scored against England in the previous three encounters put together. A bit of history beckons for these Georgian boys who are facing England at under 18s level for the first time in a dozen years today. They've never beaten England. In fact, they've never even come close. Smallest margin of defeat in those three meetings dating back to 2008 is 50 points. Here, with less than 15 minutes to go, they lead England by two.
We are 18, so 17 left.
On the water break, how
long? On the water break, 20 seconds. We are 18, 17 years old. Sorry,
17 minutes remaining. Nice clear comms from Lorenzo Negro.
Okay.
That's right. Keep an eye on that clock. 17 minutes from history for these junior Lilos. 17 minutes from sending another message to the rugby world.
Ready.
That drop of the shoulder unsettling Patrick Hogg. It's a really good clearance gathered by England. He looked to attack from deep. It's a lovely bit of movement from Finn Newton. It's a real threat. Saracen's man. The second row's working hard again. Elliot Williams into the fray.
No, stay, 12. Let's go now.
Georgia, very much been a match to the kicking duel offered by England at the moment. That's an enormous amount of pressure to be under, and Dan Green has done tremendously to take it, hold it, and win the penalty.
Off it.
Over exuberance from the Georgian chasers. Finder coming with a grunt of dissatisfaction from the fullback. Wanted more.
Stay.
Again, England go to the front. They bypass the big men in the middle. Popped on to Ollie Allport. Scored an incredible try for Gloucester against Harlequins earlier this season. In the Premiership Academy season, England, despite the scoreboard and match clock pressures, happy to continue
red on the line
to play strategically for territory.
Georgia, how many?
Four.
Let's go then.
Four.
Pressure on.
Archvadze. The man who's tried separates the sides right this moment. Picks out Saganadze.
Stay for use it.
A lot of bodies, but not a lot of length in that Georgian caterpillar, and that's why there's a lot of pressure on the clearance, and it gets touched. And England might just fancy this on the 10-metre line. Breaking one, almost two tackles. Great awareness to release the ball and go again. Tackle release called by the referee. Then more Georgian bodies pour in and the touchline's coming into focus. And a skirmish off the ball, but still we play. No look pass, then a pass to nobody, but the one bounce works out for England. Variety offered with the chip over the top, and no mark can be called because it's right on the doorstep of the 22. England looking as motivated, as hungry as they've been all game. England unhappy. Ball is out, there's the call, and like a red rag to a bull, Patrick Hogg flattens the Georgian halfback. Real energy, real desire in the way that England are going about their business, scything back inside to pop off the floor. Georgia scrambling, England in behind and with penalty advantage. Treacy carrying his team on his back. One out run, a rampaging run, but still short. Surely now for England, underneath the uprights. They retake the lead with their third score of the match. Nick Lilly, the Exeter Chief, with the big carry.
Something happened in the
and the Devonian would not be denied. Dan Green adds another pair of points to his personal ledger, but most crucially to that of England, who lead once again, and they lead by five. England 19, Georgia 14.
10 minutes. 10 left.
10 minutes of the match to go. Ample time for the pendulum of ascendancy to swing many more times. Luca Tavauri goes long. It's not taken with too much aplomb by England, but they do create a very nice angle to get a very healthy touch. Georgians take it to themselves. Foxing feet from the Georgian fullback, Kalvashi.
We are playing advantage, Georgia. Advantage there for offside.
Wondrous feet again. Solomon Shand on for an industrious cameo, making the tackle.
Well done. No advantage, number 11, offside in front of kicker.
While England, and the turnover was good, there was advantage being played. Never. Wow, this is some advantage as well for Georgia.
Offside, number 11, offside.
Rafe Whitheat, Northampton Saint. Offside, think from the clearance kick a long time ago. It's a pretty casual touch finder from Luca Tavari, but it's one that works. Because Georgia are back in the corner and they got the ball back in David Archivadze's hands. And England know all too well what can happen when he hits his man in the
okay, guys, if you call
skies.
Five players, we have to put five players. We are six. Okay, six England, six.
England don't compete. Instead, they look to sack. Have they done so illegally? Lorenzo Negro's arm is out. So the answer is yes. Georgia can throw everything at England here. They'll have another go at it if they fail. They've got this penalty advantage. The England defence, tight to the line, has stood up so well.
Okay, good control.
But
20 collapse.
Their maul defence is under real scrutiny here.
Maul was already formed, you can collapse. The maul was already
clearly formed. The tactic from England here is to sack it at source. And they're bringing on some big boys to help the cause. Aidan Ainsworth, Cave, George Knowles as well, who came up
Georgia, step back.
With the try against Wales to provide Lineker with the last minute conversion attempt that stole the victory at the death.
Easy. Palla per favore, Albi. Ball, please.
Can he come up with a massive moment on his own line here? His ballast, his power, it'll be called upon alongside the likes of Josh Mann there installed at the front. As Georgia go to the front, there's a juggle and then they turn. Because of the miscontrol, they can't build the driving maul. So England has spared that attack from the Georgians, but the assault continues to come.
16, no heads.
Hulking Georgian bodies heard round the corner, they go so close, but they're stopped half a quarter of a meter short. One pass, how low can you go? England low enough, still England deny the Georgians. Round to the left, still no way through, is it Archivadze? Archivadze on the stretch, Archivadze potentially for history.
Six. Yeah, six.
England have defended with so much discipline, so much commitment. Hemmed back on their try line, but Archivadze, with ultimate determination. And bagging a brace. Delivering a potentially momentous moment for his scrum half, Davide Tsiklari, with a conversion to take the lead. Oh, it bends, but it bends too late. It cannons off the upright. A shake of the head and a puff of the cheeks. But David Archivadze has Georgia level. And we have that grandstand finish. We have fresh bodies ready to be poured onto the field for England. Felix Bateman, Champagne,
missing Thiago,
wearing 23. Fraser Rawlins, wearing 24. It's Nick Lilly.
Mi si è staccato il cavo.
Time for running repairs required for our referee Lorenzo Negro.
Six.
And his audio equipment.
Six, yeah.
Canilla Ford to be off the field. It's his tries that have got them into this position. To maybe steal the most famous of victories, 19-all, our clock in the red. A few more minutes and seconds on the wrist of the referee Lorenzo Negro out there in the middle. The biggest scrum of the match. A lot of fresh faces in there as well. Big ballast offered on this blind side by the likes of Sol Shand. England very eager to get an early nudge on there.
Quick reset, guys. Coach! Bang! Set! Hold!
England. Oh, they advance immediately, but the service is so quick. Babakadze only knows one way, that's forward. Georgia carrying with a tepid nature, acting like a team who don't want to lose the ball, who don't want to lose the match. They don't have that swagger that they want to win, but England do, and England have the ball. Treacy first to the bounce, and there's knock-on advantage to boot. This could be the last play. England looking for Witt, backing their hands, feeding the speed. England surging down the right edge and an inside ball to steal it at the death. Georgia denied history. England and Nick Lilly surely have won this.
The ball was out. Your player take the ball out. Over.
The Exeter chief.
And then he kicked. So the wife.
The man from Ivy Bridge.
Can you watch this? I watch it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Making victory for Georgia a bridge too far.
We have to kick and two to play. You can kick. 1 minute for kick and two for play.
Well, this is the never-ending game. And I say bring it on. What a thrill. He's got two. England have the lead, but they haven't won it yet.
Okay, 10.
As much of the clock consumed by the conversion attempt from Felix Bateman Champagne. But still, there is 1 minute left. 60 seconds of drama to feast upon on this Sunday in the sun in northern Italy. What about that for the inside ball? And back on for Georgia is Iggy Siribiladze. But David Archvardze comes away with possession and knocks it on. There is still time though. Nails bitten down to the wick. Be you English or Georgian. And as attacking platforms in Last Chance Saloon go, you couldn't wish for much better. Big juicy blindside for the Georgians potentially to exploit. They must retain the ball. Their scrum was in reverse on roller skates last time, and England splinter the Georgian pack. And in doing so, they shatter their history chasing dreams.
Give up. Give up.
Sorry?
Give up. Yep. You can tap.
Tap and kick it off.
Yeah, time is over.
Yeah.
Now, 10 meters.
Dan Green. Booms out the ball. And a helter-skelter match that saw the lead and the ascendancy swing from minute one to the very last blast of Lorenzo Negro's whistle ends in jubilation for England's youngsters. A match full of character, a match full of stars for the future, and a match that sees England preserve their 100% historic record against the young Lilos.
If we can do that,
you can do dummy, yeah. But yeah. The ball is... Yeah, you can do
Archvardze
it. The ball is
there
over
on the left
the foot,
with two tries. But a brace in defeat for the young hooker.
Absolutely flat.
And the remonstrations born out of frustration of what will be looked back upon as a contest where Georgia came so close. The future's bright for both England and Georgia. What a treat these two groups of young men have dished up for us on this sunny Sunday at the Stadio Sergio Franchi. Core memories made for many of these young men out there to carry forward into whatever level of rugby they progress to. This was the opening try that Green provided the assist for after fine work from the rest of the backline division. It was Tyler Afire who docked down. And even then, England didn't lead because Georgia had slotted two early penalties after concerted pressure in the English 22. More kicks came for the Georgians. But the power from Sam Graham came from point blank range, buffeting away would-be Georgian defenders. And for Graham, his score underneath the uprights was all about power of one man. This was collective power. David Archvardze, the rejoicing hooker at the bottom of the bodies, throwing out his arms on the floor in celebration with the ball pinned to his chest. It was one more try for England to retake the lead. Lily against the grain. Lily under the uprights for an easy Dan Green conversion. But Georgia weren't done yet, and neither was David Archvardze. The England defence finally breached after disciplined and watchful resistance. But this was the magic moment that broke the game and broke Georgian hearts. Finn Newton galloping down the right edge, and the same man in Nick Lilly on hand to seal victory for England. So they may leave Northern Italy with a 100% win record in this under 18 Six Nations Festival. A thriller in Northern Italy. A real joy. Full time in the Six Nations under 18 Festival. England 26, Georgia 19.
Another one.